there is a similar nature between the code of software and the code of life. We are all very familiar with digital as being ones and zeros. We are also familiar with the four bases of DNA, G, A, T, C, in two different ways, which are very similar in nature. Those systems operate with simple bases that combine together to create extraordinary accomplishments.
mRNA is an information molecule, right? It carries digital information with it. You take this information molecule, you can code in anything you want in it, and it'll produce an entirely different protein.
When COVID was analyzed and sequenced, we received an equation, a code, over the internet. And based on that code, we built the mRNA that would actually create the spike protein and create the immunogenic response that is the vaccine. This makes us much more a tech company than a pharmaceutical company or a biology company. We are an organization that meets the code of life, which is DNA and mRNA and ribosomes to proteins, with the code of software, that is AI models, that is transactional, API-driven, interactive elements that connect to each other for the platform that we are creating for the world.
mRNA is digital at its core. mRNA is a technology platform. So COVID vaccine is only one use case of what mRNA can do. It can be applied to many other therapeutic areas and many other diseases.
That means that tomorrow, if we have a breakthrough in nanolipids technology or mRNA technology for rare disease, that breakthrough might also be a breakthrough for oncology. No single product, no single therapeutic area is more important than the whole of the platform, which covers all of them together.
So we have to prioritize the platform. We have to prioritize the technology. Some of these things are not going to work out, and that's fine. But as long as we're progressing the platform forward, we will be more successful. And we think about that from the digital perspective, in the sense that everything we do is in service of the platform. We don't do some project or some AI algorithm for one particular, you know, disease indication, right? We do it for the platform as a whole, so that no matter what happens, we're progressing things.
mRNA is such an interesting technology, a net new technology like the world hasn't seen before. Why? Because beforehand, we needed to throw everything but the sink into the bloodstream of people to take care of the side effects of things that were happening to them. Now we can enter the cell and go straight to the cause of things that are happening to them. This enables us to potentially address 85% of the burden of disease, of things that put people into the hospital. Oncology, virology, rare disease, diabetes, hereditary conditions, cellular activity, metabolism, heart failures, you name it, everything that is either originated or influenced by cellular mechanism potentially has a solution within the range of mRNA.
Messenger RNA is a platform. Whether you're building one vaccine or another, what you're changing inside the vaccines is the antigen sequence. All the learning that you get from one sequence or one vaccine, you can use it for all the other vaccines that you're working on. And this is the power of our platform. And this is why we are really focused on how we accelerate the learning inside the company, because there's a huge network effect. Once you have a learning in one space, you can have it in all the other spaces. And that's the key piece of why we've been able to very quickly move from two vaccines before COVID that were in phase one to COVID, where we went from phase one to phase three and then into the market. So all this learning is captured because we have a platform and because we are using data to improve the learning inside the platform.
It is unprecedented that in the world of life science, a single type of chemistry covers such a huge range of potential difficulties and burdens of disease for humans. This is why the platform means so much to us, both from the mRNA standpoint and also from the digital standpoint.